We present a new algorithm to generate human-like trajectories for crowd simulation. We base our model on the principle of least effort. In 1949, George Zipf wrote, "An organism will expend the least average rate probable of work, as estimated by itself." Applying PLE to locomotion essentially boils down to finding the trajectory which requires the least effort. As compared to previous PLE-based algorithms, our novel contributions are, we define effort as energy expended during locomotion, we represent this mathematically with formulae taken from established biomechanics literature, and we provide an online, real-time simulator that supports thousands of independent agents. Whittle provides the following equation relating instantaneous power to walking speed. The E sub S term captures the energy cost of simply being alive. E sub W captures the biomechanical efficiency of locomotion. Adhering to PLE, an agent's ideal path would minimize the total energy across its trajectory. Minimizing energy across the length of the entire simulation is an intractable problem. We approximate the solution inductively, in a local, greedy fashion, based on two terms: the true cost of the immediate path and the cost of the approximated remaining path. We note that the effort function defines an optimal speed, which is in fact the average human walking speed. This serves as supporting evidence for the validity of this metric as an effort model. In simple cases, it is possible to analytically determine the optimal path for an agent. Here we show a single case of two agents exchanging positions. On the left, we show the PLE results. On the right, we show the results from a social force-based algorithm. The PLE trajectories consume only 1% more than the optimal amount of energy, while the social force-based model exceeds it by 17%. Using PLE, we observe many of the common emergent phenomena in crowds. Here we show three such phenomena: jamming, arching, and the wake effect. As multiple agents converge on a narrow passage, they interfere with each other, obstructing the flow. Jamming leads other agents to pile up behind them. The stalled agents form a semicircular arch around the narrow passage. Finally, as agents leave the narrow passage, they disperse only as necessary, leaving the corners near the passage empty. This scenario shows a crowd's edge effect and uneven densities. Members of the dense crowd in a passage near the edges are able to move more quickly than those in the congested center. In addition, despite the high average density of the agents, small pockets form in the crowd. As shown in the paper, our metric leads to smooth paths. Here, we see 10 agents smoothly walking past each other. Other planning algorithms may struggle to achieve similarly smooth paths, as shown. Here we show congestion avoidance in an open environment. Because becoming stalled in congestion costs more energy than going around it, agents plan around congestion that they can see and are capable of avoiding. Again, other planning algorithms typically fail to achieve the same effect. Congestion avoidance should still occur in environments with many obstacles. In this scenario, each agent's goal is the exit farthest from its initial position. This was explicitly chosen to maximize potential congestion. In the PLE simulation on the left, agents plan new paths to better utilize the available free space on the trade show floor in order to avoid the developing congested regions. In the simulation without PLE, shown on the right, agents head into the congestion developing along their shortest path. We now compare the results of our method to those from real humans walking. Here is the data from various researchers on how increasing density slows down people's walking speed. When that same data was collected from a PLE simulation, the results match closely with those from the human studies. Finally, we present a side-by-side comparison of actual footage taken at the intersection near Shibuya Metro Station in Tokyo. The overall pattern of movement in the simulation is very similar to that seen in the actual footage. Both cases show lane formation, dispersal to reduce congestion, and continuous flow. We have presented a novel formulation for crowd simulation based on a biomechanical realization of the principle of least effort. To the best of our knowledge, this is the first such PLE-based system capable of producing many observable, natural crowd phenomena at real-time rates. Because of its focus on real human paths, we envision our method being used not only in games and movies, but in areas such as training and simulation where accuracy is important.